Now we're moving on to the, we just did the cycloid, epicycloid, and now we're gonna move on to the hypocycloid. So we're gonna finish the series of cycloids. Now, the procedures, as I said before, are the same for this one and this one and this one. The only difference is these are rolling on the internal and external of a circle. So this one is on the internal of the base circle, and this one is on external. Or the exterior of the base circle. Now you have three major things to focus on. Focus on that difference over here. The center is in line with 3 and 9. Over here, the center is very different from 3 and 9. So the center line starts from the center of the circle here, while 3 and 9 is in line because it's a curve. It curves over the center of the circle and goes all the way to 3 here. Right. So the center line is different for the epi and hypocycloid. As we found out before, that the formula for finding the angle at which we should divide the base circle is here by putting the diameter of the rolling circle over the diameter of the base circle, so it's 60 over 180 times 360, and you get 120 as the answer. Alright, so now we will form this shape here. So the first thing to do is to get the base circle. The base circle is 180 diameter and 90 radius. Right. So we'll start with our center line. Nope, it's not a center line. Use construction line for now. Boom. Turn on ortho. So we get all the straight lines. Alright, so the first step is to draw a circle. It's 90. Alright, so 90 that radius gives you diameter. So now this circle is on the inside, which is the same as this 30. So we just select a point. So we want to select 30 just like over there. So the angle would be 30, 150 on this side, 50, 160, 150. Good. And 120 on this side, as 120 is the angle. Remember, the angle is obtained here, 120. So 30 on both sides of a 180 flat line gives us 120 in the center. So 30 there, good. Now what we can do next is to, this is our rolling base circle, so we want to draw a rolling circle now. So from this point, we form 30. Gives us our 60 circle, and we move this inwards. The last time we moved, let's check just to make sure that it is the right size. So boom, and 30. Okay, very good. So move this internally from this point to this point. All right, next step is to divide this circle in 12. But before we do that, we don't trim this. TR, enter, we'll trim from here to here. Now we divide this into 12 and this into 12. This is our base circle, or our base here. So we roll the circumference onto here. So what we're going to do is divide into 12, divide. How many segments? 12. Enter. Then connect them. And notice, pass through the center point, run all the way to the next side. And to draw fast, I just keep using enter. So enter, 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 right? Escape and enter are your best friends when you're using AutoCAD. Enter, command goes away. Enter, it comes back. Enter, goes away. Enter, it comes back. Enter, goes away. Enter, it comes back. I just keep using enter. Right, same thing for this, so divide. Select 12, enter. And now I can draw from the center point here. Boom, all the way to this, to my line divisions. The only difference between this one is that our divisions was on this base circle here, but our base circle is on the outside this time. So divisions are connected to the base circle on the outside. after we do this, we want to divide, we want to radiate our lines, our radial lines from each point on the circle all the way around. So last time we did it from here upwards, now we're going to do it from upwards downwards. Alright, so we get the diameter, circle, radius from here to this point, that's the minimum point, enter, from here to here, enter, so just keep using the enter, enter, here to here, center point now, enter, here to here, right here, right here, right here, alright, and trim the extras. You may read the instructions for yourself so you can get a more vivid and clear understanding. Remember, the book is always posted and the information is always posted in your classroom, so pay attention to that. Alright, so now we have everything. So all that we need to do now is to plot the points, right? So remember, this is here. The zero is on the base circle at all times, so the zero would be right here. So it's basically turning this upside down or inside out then. So the curve wouldn't be like that, the curve would be upside down. That's what we're doing. So this is our zero point here, our point P. We're starting from here. So let's change this to center line. From the centers, so we scribe from center 1 on line 1, center 2 on line 2, center 3 on line 3, center 4 on line 4, and we do that all the way over to like this, and then we do it the other way. So center 1, line 1, center 2, line 2. All right, let's do it. Center start end, so center 1 here. Scribe on line 1, there. So 30. Alright, so we want to change the line type just so we have a better visibility. So from 0 to 1, there, right? And come all the way around. So we're going to get that done. So change the line type to hidden so we can see it more clearly. Center start end. From center 1 to center 2 now, to line 2. Line 2 is there. So 30, enter, line 2. That's us. Same thing again. Center start end. Center 1, center 2, center 3, center 4. Center 3 now. Center 1, 2, 3, to line 3 here. So 30. Oh man. Don't do this at all. So point 1, point 2, point 3. Notice we're coming around like this to go that way. So 0, 1, 2, 3. So center 4 is here. Are we missing anything? Nope. Center 4, 5. Alright, good. So the next one. From center 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 from here. And scribe on this one here. So it's 30. And scribe this way. Excellent. And then from here. Point to start end. From center 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If it works better for you to label them, you label your points as you go along. As you notice, they're all labeled here. So if you want to label it so you can get a better understanding of how to do it, go ahead. So center 5, line 5 is right here. So 30, enter. Let's grab it here. Boom. Then center 5, no, 6 now. 6 is here, so it would have to be this point. Boom. And then go 30. Let's grab Right, and right in the peak, right? So you have half of it already coming all the way like this. Then we need the next half. So continue the same fashion. So center 6, center 7, the line 7, and 30. So this blue arrow, this blue writing there tells us what measurement it is, but we type 30 to ensure that it's perfectly 30. That is 30 right there. But we type it in and enter to ensure that we get 30 exact and it sticks there. Right, so boom. Next step, 8. So 7, 8, and line 8 is here. So come down to 30. Right here, 30, enter, boom. And so line 8, 6, 7, 8, 6, 7, 8, 9. I'm afraid that was the wrong one. So start again. So 6, 7, 8 now. Send the start end. 6, 7, 8. Here. I'll turn it this way. Oh, it's the same thing. Okay. My bad. That's a 7, 8, 6, 7, 8, 9. From 9 to 30. Go there. Enter. Let's grab there. Then set the start end. So 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Here to 30. There. Right there. Alright. So now we do boom. Set the start end. 10, 11, so 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, so 11, let's grab 30 there, let's grab right there, and then this one touches there. So that's it for us. So we just use spline to find the rest now. SPL, enter, and then connect all points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. That's it. That's our hypocycloid. It is not as curvilinear as these ones, but it is what it is. It is a hypocycloid. And we did it. We did it. We did it. We did it. Hooray! Bellissimo. Well, it doesn't look exactly like these ones because these ones are basically sketches. They are not necessarily drawn to any scale, but these are scaled versions of the actual thing. They give us a measurement to work with. These are not drawn to any specific measurement. That's why they look a little bit different. But here you go. So, MA. Yeah, we did it. We did it. We did it. Hooray, when I see you. Come on, Bob. Let's go. Everybody, let's go. Come on, let's get to it. I know that we can do it. What are we drawing? Foolishness. What are we drawing? Foolishness. Alright. Because of bam. Oh, we're done. Basically. Alright, so now all you do is do your labeling, your lettering, and we are good. So all the time you letter and label as you have it here on your instructions. And please remember while you're drawing, just keep all the drawing together. Save your drawings on your email. So that means you can always find it when you need to. Or if needs be, you can find it. So save your drawings in your email so that if your card account should crash, you can, you will have it, or you can recover. So hypo cycloid. All right, there you go.